You're watching the Eyewitness News Network. This is Eyewitness News Tonight.
Good evening, and thanks for being with us tonight. Well, the Buffalo Bills take a beating in the big bowl game.
That's right. The Washington Redskins took it to them. The final, in case you haven't heard yet, Washington 37, Buffalo 24. Neil Beasley joins us now, and Neil, it was a blowout from the get-go.
Yeah. Well, it kind of seemed that way. You know, the first quarter was just about like any other big game, whether it's football or not, as they were just kind of feeling each other out, you know, and you had some great plays and you had some good defensive plays, but no scoring. And then it all took over in the second quarter. The Washington Redskins decided to go on a tear, just like they did a couple of Super Bowls back against the Denver Broncos. This time out, they scored 17 points in the second quarter, 17 unanswered points against the Buffalo Bills is exactly right. Buffalo came back to make it 24-10 and had it close, and they had some momentum going as well. But Washington went on, scored again to make it 31-10 in the third quarter, and for all intents and purposes, that was pretty much the game. Mark Rippon, the quarterback for Washington, was the game's MVP, threw only one interception, 292 yards on 18 completions, a couple touchdowns. And Alex and Kevin, again, the final 37-24, Washington doing a number, and I think when you look back, the NFC, it just has a stranglehold on the AFC in the title game.
Should have listened to you last night, because you predicted it.
I said by 14, so if I would have given away 14 points, I would have lost, but they did win by 13.
Yeah, always trust the sports guy.
You know it was going to happen.
Thank you, Neil. Well, Neil, fans weren't the only ones at the game today. There were lots of activist groups at the Metrodome, too. More than 2,000 people used the Super Bowl as a platform to voice concerns on everything from abortion to veterans' rights. One of the largest groups protested against the use of American Indian nicknames and mascots in sports.
We can't get rid of these mascots. If we can't get rid of this John Wayne frontier mentality that exists in America, we'll never be able to deal with these other more important issues.
The American Indian speakers were met with mild applause and a few jeers. Some Redskins fans even dressed in full headdresses, but they seemed unimpressed with the protest. Dozens of police kept an eye on demonstrations. There were no arrests reported.
Here at home, plenty of folks know the Super Bowl is more than an excuse to throw a ball. It's an excuse to have a ball. And so they did at the Henby Organ household in Sioux Falls. We stopped by for their sixth annual Super Bowl bash and found football fans of all ages cheering their heroes and chiding their friends.
I think the Super Bowl is just more than just gathering. I think it's the food. The food is pretty much the key to success, essential of the Super Bowl. Is there a game going on?
Everybody agreed the food and the company couldn't be better, even when the game wasn't quite going their way. The host of the party may have summed it up the best, though.
Why do you think people get together like this to watch the Super Bowl?
It's like a holiday. It's better than Christmas.
You can be sure they will be at it again next Super Bowl.
In other news, Democratic presidential candidate